This video is about the Cauchy's theorem for multiply connected regions. Now, in this video, we will see some consequences of Cauchy's theorem, and we will also prove Cauchy's theorem for multiply connected region. Now, if you watched the previous videos, you will know what is multiply connected region. So, a multiply connected region is a region like this shaded part in between two closed curves. Now see this is the according to the positive sign convention, this arrow and this arrow, our left hand will be in the region. Now we have to prove the Cauchy's theorem, which is integration along these two curves, which is integration along C is zero. So how we will do this? We will first convert this multiply connected region to a simply connected region. How? We will make a cut in here. We'll make a cut and name this A, B. Now, this is something like this now. Now, this itself is a simply connected region. So, we converted a multiply connected region into a simply connected region. Now, we will integrate. How we will integrate? In most of the book, they give names like G, E, F, D, E, then A, B, then here, then go back. But I will simply say this whole above integration as C1, this one as C2, and according to the positive sign convention, and this A to B and then B to A. This makes things simpler. But in books, you will find like letter writing from here to here. They simply tell us the direction. So now I will tell you direction by myself. So I've used this. So now we make a cut AB to convert this multiply connected region to simply connected region. Now according to the formula, this formula of Cauchy integral formula, we have integration along this curve that is simply connected region. Now C1, which is this in positive direction, we have not taken a negative sign. If we take a negative sign, then we will go opposite of everything. So positive sign convention, positive integration along C1, then from A to B, then integration along C2, positive region is inside, region is to our left now, and then B to A. This is our integration. Now we know things about definite integrals. We can break them up into parts. So we break them into parts to C1, then A to B, then C2, then B to A. Now simply we can see that integration along A to B is equal to integration along B to A with a negative sign. Just opposite of each other. These are two opposite of each other. So they cancel each other. Now we are left with these two. Now integration along C1 fz dz, which is positive, which is this one integration, and integration which is this one, is zero, which is in fact saying this integration along the whole curve is zero, C1 and C2. So this proves the Cauchy integral theorem for multiply connected region, that it is valid for multiply connected region also. Now a very important consequence from here and the sign convention. This consequence is more used than this proof, so understand it very carefully, because you will prove the Cauchy integral formula by that consequence, and also the residue theorem, which is very important theorem in complex analysis, with that formula. So understand that very carefully. Instead of writing this as complete curve and then zero, we will do something else. We will take this curve and make it direction opposite. So converting this to this, we have two curves now. This have this inside region and this have this as inside region now. And the sign becomes negative because of our sign convention. Now we have this one, just change the sign and the integration changes like this. And we will take this to the other side, become positive, and we get integration along C1 fz dz is equal to integration along C2 fz dz. So this is telling that if there is any closed curve and there is another closed curve in it, then integration along that curve is equal to integration along that inside curve. Now we will generalize this. Now this thing itself is very important in solving problems related to Cauchy theorem, and also it will help us to prove many other things. So remember this. Now we will generalize this to understand it better. If there is a closed curve C and there are infinite number of curves in it with direction to this one, so that the inside curves becomes negative if they come to this side, then integration along C f that dz is equal to integration along c1, c2, c3 and so on of fz dz. That is, integration along this curve is equal to the sum of integration along this and infinite number of curves like this. So in multiply connected regions there are curves inside curves. So we will just change the sign and got this consequence of Cauchy theorem. So this is a very important consequence of Cauchy theorem. So this is how you prove Cauchy theorem for multiply connected region. So thanks for watching this video, and always remember that math is everything.